just a quick look ahead at a couple of the games coming up. Up next, we have Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, ran by pok3monrocks. After that, Barbie Game Girl by John Carls, followed by Speedy Gonzales, Los Gatos Bandidos by Keverage.
Move your mic closer. I'll buy one.
Oh, yeah.
I'll just say that. Oh.
Countdown, are you ready? All right, so I'll give you a countdown in five, four, three, two, one, go. So first thing I'm going to point out real quick is there's multiple things. Oh, my God, I just said the word aeroplane. I'm so sorry. I was not thinking. Well, then there goes that. Anyways, there's two things. There's a bunch of cutscenes, and they're mostly jarring black screens that are green hourglasses. And then there's other jarring black screens with Harry Potters. Those are load screens. There's many, many cutscenes like scattered throughout the run. So if it fades to like anything black with a green hourglass, that's just a cutscene. Right there, I did Willow Jump, and I did a little setup there. So, because it's a first one-shot trick, and from Willow Jump, I can just come over to these little boundaries over here and push myself against this wall, preferably jump. And now we're out of bounds. And this just saves like 10 seconds. So, there's the level. I'm just going to go to the end.
Streamer, why don't you use software rendering?
Oh, so there's two different types of rendering for this game. One is software and one is direct 3D. Software is very unstable as of right now, and we kind of have to like talk about it in the community. But there's a bunch of different bugs visually that make the game a little bit more appealing, but also very confusing, I guess. But for Direct 3D, we can limit our frame rate. So on these PCs, I can make software work where it's not too high. But for safety, I prefer Direct 3D because I can limit it to the preferred frame rate. Another like interesting mechanic I'm going to mention now, and it's going to come up really quickly, is before I started this run, a week ago, well, not really a week ago, but like a couple weeks ago, we found out that by Max G. He found out that if you bound one key to have the same input twice, you'd go faster in terms of acceleration, and then your max speed is reached and you go the same speed after that. But it works equally the same by binding it to two keys. So I'm using eight keys to move around at some points, depending on what direction I'm moving.
But streamer, do you use eight fingers to actually control yourself?
No, I only have three controlling the WASD, and oh wait, I don't even use the WASD anymore. That was old strats. And while I was doing that, I just basically skipped a bunch of the stairs, and we made it to the classroom. And from here, these are the arrow key challenges, and they're really painful to sit through for the runner.
Concentrate on the symbol in front of you.
A new trick was found where I now have to do this arrow key challenge, but these have very picky inputs, and if I miss a key, it's basically the game. It's called a fake input, and it will fail the input correctly in order to progress to the next round. So hopefully I can hit all these inputs. If I fail one, I have to redo this entire section.
Yeah, this game is kind of finicky, and it just likes to not let you pass the mission for whatever reason.
So that's one of three.
Well done, Harry. You've advanced to the next round.
Five points
to Gryffindor. Round two, begin.
So now, as you go on, the rounds get more inputs. So it just makes it a bit more challenging and more chances for fake inputs. So I'm going to pray that it doesn't happen here. It probably will happen in Scourge. Rictus Emperor and Scourge are probably the most common fake input to the next areas. Round.
10 points to Gryffindor.
This one is probably the most
Round three,
common out of all of them.
Begin.
I almost got one too. All right, there we go.
Wow, well done, Harry. Well done.
Well done.
All right, so now that we've finished the arrow key challenge, I have the exercise. One of the newest skips in the game that was done a week ago. And it saves 3.5 minutes, and if I fail it, I can always retry. Ah, dang. So what I'm trying to do there with a new tech, from buying two keys, is I have just enough speed to get to that door and then leave this area before it even starts. So I wouldn't have to go through this entire section. I am going to kill myself from these snails, and then I'm going to... It will force me back into the start of this area, and... From that, I have another shot, but it does waste time taking all this damage from the snails and getting here. But hopefully it won't take too long. This skip does save 3.5 minutes, so if I take a couple tries to get it, it's perfectly fine. So here we go, let's try again. Ah, so close. So this trick is so finicky because if you hit the right portion of the wall, it pushes you further into it. And you're trying to avoid one of the little beams pushing you closing. And that's basically all I'm trying to do is I'm trying to get there before that top beam closes. I guess I'll try one more time. If not, then I might just do this whole level. It's not too big of a deal if I don't get this trick, but I would like to show it off. Okay, snail. If not, Rickston has a bunch of interesting strats in it. Alright, so let's try one more time. Nice! Alright, so now we don't have to do Rickasempra. And we just basically leave the area. And now we're going to the beam bonus room. And before, we had a 1 in 8 chance of getting good RNG here. Now it's a 1 in 2 because we skipped Richard Sempra. And I got bad RNG. Typical. Marathon.
Of course.
Nice. That only weighs 10 seconds from best RNG, so that's a lot more than 30 seconds if you had the absolute worst RNG. So I'll take it. But there's nothing to do here. I just have to wait. And after this, I have to go through a bunch of auto-scrollers as well. So I guess now if you have time for donations, this is probably like the best point.
All right. We have $15 from Lowe's Viken. Heyo, people. Shoutouts to the Harry Potter community. Money goes to runner's choice. 15 more is coming if you don't get any double inputs in DDR. Also, watch out for my bludgers.
I'll definitely watch out for those bludgers.
$50 from Halil. Good day from Australia. Best of luck to the runners.
Use your arrow keys to steer your broom left, right, up.
$20 from Fide Caro, I hope I pronounced that right. Thanks for playing my childhood game. And thanks for this great event. Kind regards from Switzerland. Good luck, and take my Birdie Bots Beans donation.
That's it, Harry. You've almost got it.
An anonymous $10 donation that says, just realized that SGDQ is happening this week. Obviously, I have to donate to such a great cause. Greetings from Germany. This money goes towards killing the animals. We have to win this time.
Oh, okay, so in this round, we now have a Seeker, and this Seeker can waste us like 3 seconds, but if you just kill her right away, then she can hit you, and she won't come back, so now the Stitch is free. And then from here, we're going to go to Potion's Quest, and hopefully avoid the only soft lock in the game, but that's a very rare and very rare chance it happens, and no one knows why. If it does, I'll just continue on from that little autosave right there. So, we're going to the dungeon. In here, we're going to make one Wiggenweld healing potion. And this Wiggenweld healing potion will be the only potion, hopefully, that I make throughout this entire run. I can make one later on, but it wastes like 15 seconds, and I have to pick up an extra Boomslang skin. But if I open this chest instead on this little spot right here, I pick up both items before they even come out, and I wait for him to say now, and I wait for him to say observe. I don't have to wait for him to say observe, but I'm playing at a certain frame rate that makes it so that if I don't wait for observe, I don't get my potion. So I do have to wait for observe. I waited for now because if I went and hit the cauldron right away, Harry would just stand there and the cutscene wouldn't advance. So that's one of the softlocks. The second softlock in that area, Harry like slides out of the cutscene, and that one no one knows how to stop. Oh no, I messed up the movement tech here. We good though.
We have $20 from Sir Boris. Donated because I loved the Harry Potter games as a kid. All this music
Try
is giving me
on all this
so much nostalgia.
Of secrets, Balderdash. Concentrate on the symbol in front of you. The wand is about to move its way around the symbol. At the exact point when the wand
like
passes
said,
over the arrows,
DDR.
You'll need to
I'm
hit the
using
corresponding
the
arrow
keys.
Arrow key.
It's
this exercise
challenge.
Has three levels. In each
this
level,
one is
you must successfully hit
and
all of the
Spotify.
Arrows in sequence.
I'm going
to
do all four of them.
Round one.
I already
go.
Did. And hopefully nothing happens wrong where I don't have to like repeat a loop. But this one is the second most likely to have a fake input. And usually it's on the third round on the second set of arrows. So if it happens there, then it's probably a fake input.
Well,
it can happen anywhere in these
You've
two.
You've advanced
like,
to the next level of the lesson. 5 points
Streamer, when are you
going to
do this on a dance
round
pad?
Round two. Go.
I'm not hooking up my dance pad. I need, like, good games and a good dance pad.
It's a shame. Don't forget your dance moves.
I could do this on a dance pad, just easy.
That sounds like a challenge to me.
Well done, Harry.
Okay.
You've advanced right, to the next
SGDQ
level
2017,
of the
dance 10 pad, Harry Potter 2.
Gryffindor. Round three, go!
That one was actually my fault. That was not a fake input. I'm gonna own up to my mistakes. So that just wastes 18 seconds. I have to redo this whole little loop.
Give it another try.
Give it another try, Harry.
Don't waver, Harry. You almost have it down.
Okay, there we go.
Well done!
No fake input on Scourge. That one was my mistake.
Exercises.
Oh. Run goes on.
15 points to Gryffindor.
So in Scourge, we are introduced to Ectoplasm. And Ectoplasm really just are barriers that are placed throughout the challenges to stop you. I'll be avoiding all these Ectoplasms as much as possible because they're really far away and I can just hit them. Oh, wow. This is a moving platform boost. If you get some acceleration from Harry and some acceleration
ectoplasm
from the platform,
takes away some of your stamina.
They
can the
like bind together
ectoplasm,
and I can cross gaps that I'm not supposed to. That one I'm actually supposed to push the block all the way to the left, or all the way forward. And hi, Peeves. Bye, Peeves.
Good fight.
But the moving platform boost is very simple and. There used to be a lot more in the run, but those were in the Willow section. Yeah, this is a skip in the game. If you just like walk across the little beam that it spins on and just jump, then if you're in the corner, it stops it entirely. There's been like, three different skips for that. Oh, whoops. Oh no, I fell. Oh, that's like 10 seconds, no big deal. Oh, what? So there's no... Okay. I was supposed to hit both of those ectoplasms. I'm not sure why I didn't hit the second one. And then this is basically the end of Scourge. I just have to go through like two more rooms and one final skip in this area. And I need to run a jump here. I don't know how many runs I've lost because I just don't jump. Oh, nice. Ledge boost. This game can give like very weird properties out of ledges. One of them is a ledge boost, and there we go. That's the oh, that's another ledge boost. That was the skill skip. Before, if you were doing this casually, you'd have to place a block on top of one of them, one of the platforms to raise it up, and then just like sort of walk on top of it and just go to the end. But instead, I'm just gonna jump around the trigger that allows it to see where Harry is, and you can just use that to get to the end right away.
We have $10 from Fazin, donating for Chamber of Secrets. It was the first PC game I learned how to modify the .ini file to change damage values as I couldn't beat the final boss without it. Nice to see somebody doing it in a far more legit way. Donation goes to Runner's Choice.
Speaking of Runner's Choice, what like incentives are coming up recently? Or what incentives are coming up?
We have Mega Man 8 to play on the Saturn version, Ratchet and Clank, Zem sings the Star-Spangled Banner, The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening DX, Red Tunic or Blue Tunic. Obviously, the Red Tunic is the superior choice. And then Bioshock for the ending choice, good versus bad, and a couple of Dishonored.
Put it towards Brickmore Witches, not Knife of Dunmore.
What was that?
Brickmore Witches.
Okay, we'll go toward that then.
Thank you.
So this is the dungeon quest. In here, we're trying to go find one of the ingredients for the Polyjuice Potion. And throughout this area, there's a bunch of little puzzles. These snails here. This one I hit early on, so I pushed it twice. Oh, wow. Dang, usually you only have to push that snail in twice. And then these crabs, they just kind of go towards their desired area. You line up correctly. Here's a giant room with a staircase. I don't like stairs, I like falling. You don't take any damage from that if you land on the stairs. And you basically just don't need to be like that. So these snails were actually the snails above us, and now they're alive again, and they do the same again. So they're pretty simple. You can angle your spells a little bit, so I can pull off. You can angle some spells a little bit, so I kind of casted the spell like as I was turning. And that caused it to like arc a little bit. See, I can grab the ledge. Oh no. That ledge is. This gnome's in the wrong spot. Okay. That ledge is very finicky. It saves like 2 seconds if I grab it. I'm just gonna take the damage here. And this is better than the Dry Storage 7, I believe. By good old friend Merp. And really, it saves 0.7 seconds compared to the other solution to that puzzle, so I probably lost the time compared to the pendant solution. But it's okay, because who named the trick seven. It's amazing. Okay. This area has a lot of interesting collision. There's a bunch of platforms out in the center, and I can skip them by doing a very few precise jumps. That last one is by far the hardest, and I'm glad I got that first try without having to set it up too much. But that skips having to wait for all the little platforms in the middle, and that saves like 8 seconds roughly. And then this is just the final climb to the end of the level. And this section, okay. The collision coming off of that edge is very wonky, and it's very easy to just sort of fall to your death if you're not careful. And so here's the Bicorn Horn, one of the ingredients we need for the Polyjuice Potion. And now we get to go beat up Slytherin, aka Malfoy.
I'm in the potions classroom. Better keep an eye out for Snape.
Hi, would you consider a trade?
You're not getting my shiny blue eyes white dragon today.
The Barry Paul of Greed.
And some of my Hand of Exodia? Okay. So, coming right here, there's a duel with Malfoy. The optimal strat is I can use 2 Decembras to basically take an entire life bar. If it doesn't happen, that's just because I probably mistimed one of them. But it's a fairly straightforward fight.
Today, Potter, pleasure of dueling the great Slytherin
house. Oh, dude, he knows.
Don't play, dude.
What? Dude, this guy is being annoying.
Wow. You're being really upright right now.
Okay, here we go. There we go. Normally he's not supposed to reflect the second one. I guess I was a bit too slow, but oh well. He can be kind of a jerk sometimes. So coming up is Defindo, and Defindo is one of the longest levels of the challengers. And it's also a hidden auto-scroller. There's a global cycle I have to make, and that global cycle is not really sped up at all. There is one trick, the memeiest trick of this entire run called the Findo Skip, that saves 40 seconds, and I'll go for it once, but odds are I won't get it. It involves a ledge boost that is very precise, and it puts me out of bounds.
See the pointer?
And no one knows how to activate a ledge boost, so I'm not going to even go into it.
When the pointer passes directly over the arrow,
fun fact about this arrow key challenge, if I do it, I only save 1 second.
This exercise
so
is in
if you want to save frames, or just even a second,
you must be accurate in order
you can
to
do this arrow key challenge, or you can fail it on the first round and only lose 1 second.
Go.
But I like the seconds, so I'm going to get my second.
Always save the frames.
Speaking of which, you should definitely save frames. Always.
Well done, Harry.
Always save frames.
You've moved on to the next level of the lesson.
Always save frames.
5 points.
Are you saying we should kill the animals?
Yes, I'm saying we should kill the animals. I wasn't going to say which one because I didn't remember off the top of my head. I was going to say save first, and then realize that might have been wrong.
Well, like how you think.
Here's a little phrase I remember up by. Save the frames, kill
well
the animals.
Done, Harry.
Like that.
You've moved on to the next level of the lesson. 10 points to Gryffindor.
Yo, round 10 points three, to Gryffindor.
Go.
Grats, dude.
Yes.
Dude, I can get 15 points right here.
Whoa, that's crazy.
Alright, 15 points
well
to Gryffindor.
Done.
Amazing.
You've
Harry Caring.
All
I can't
of
believe
these answers in top form. 15 points to Gryffindor.
Amazing.
Oof. So, as it starts out, it puts us like in the middle of this room, when even though you start out like at the door. We've tried to skip to Findo because you start right next to the door, but it's very hard, and I don't think it's even possible from what we've tested with it. But if there was any other challenge that we could skip, it would be to Findo. And if we did, it would save a lot of time. These snails, if I put this room correctly, this one is one of those bushes. I might go in 3 here because, okay, no. Because I was going a bit too fast. I need this chocolate frog. Alright, thank you.
Pork lump mushrooms.
This cutscene I can't skip. So, enjoy pork lump mushrooms.
Avoid them, or use Defindo to cut their stems.
Alright, good tutorial.
Once you've separated a hork lump from its stem, pick it up.
So normally in this room, you'd raise both platforms and then jump across those, but if you just raise the one, you can get all the way up to the top here. And I had to remind myself not to do that little time saver to get to the score. I like to like go really fast in these sections, so I try and like optimize my frames, and in that little fall there, I try to fall as soon as possible. But if I fall too fast, I just die. There's this whole section over here, but if I look this way, I can just use, I can target the Defindo rope that I need to cut with. I can cut that rope with Defindo, much lower than I'm supposed to. And that just basically skips going up there. And this, we're coming up to the Defindo skip, but it's gonna like take a little bit. And if I get it, I get it. And if I don't get it, I don't get it. It's basically that.
We have $10 from Anonymous that simply says 10 points to Gryffindor. $10 from Obsidian Eagle. Had to donate from my favorite childhood game, Flipendo. Donation is runner's choice.
I always thought it said Nintendo.
I'm a scientist. No, I was trying to avoid this entire game. Don't start this.
I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. I'm pretty sure like a bunch of the people in the Harry Potter community are saying it. Just for memes. Okay, so I got a ledge boost, but it was not high enough. Basically, the top of this wall, and you go straight to the end. It's very finicky, and no one knows how to trigger a ledge boost, really. And this is the cycle I was talking about. I just had to wait for the snail to charge me. So, going for Defindo skip there, didn't waste any time at all. I still had to wait for the cycle. That's the cycle I had to make, and now from here on out, I just have to go fast. There's not a whole lot in the test of Defindo. Mainly Defindo is to get rid of all these barriers and obstacles and bring things closer to you, in a way. So, a lot of these are just webs, tree roots, and then webs that I'm using. Right here, I use an moving platform boost off of the little bridge extension. If I go too early, the bridge scissors me and I die. And if I go too soon, I don't even get any health. So, took that one a bit slower. I used chocolate frogs, so I took so much damage from that one fall. And this is the end of Finno. Here there's 3 snails. First one I get 1 snail, and the second one I have 2 snails. This one I want to charge me, it's much faster than flipping all the way over here. So I'm gonna wait for him to get over there. Oh yeah, challenge stars. I completely forgot they were even in the game. So challenge stars, we used to avoid them entirely in Route to Sempra. But now that we don't go to Route to Sempra anymore, we don't have to worry about them as much. Really, challenge stars just add more house points, and before, when it was a 1 in 8 chance for like bad RNG, that was mainly referring to your house point RNG. And that house point RNG depends on how long you spend in the first beam bonus room. So we avoid the challenge stars as much as possible, and if you collect too many of them, you go back to the beam bonus room, because your house points are close enough to Slytherin's. And that's really all it checks for, is your house points to Slytherin to see how long you spend in the beam bonus room. Right here, we're going into Boom Slang Skin. This is the second and final ingredient, or not second final, second and last ingredient for Poison Potion. And this is, I believe,
Defindo!
Merp found a lot of strats.
Defindo!
Oh wow, I got good RNG on these mushrooms. I can just, you know, go on this mushroom and come up here. This strat was found a long time ago. I can't remember the name, and I'm sorry. The person who found that, but this one here is the Shroom Stack, or I believe it's better than Dry Storage 8. Merp likes names things better than Dry Storage. I'm not sure why. But here, I have to get rid of all these venomous tentaculas, and that mushroom's gonna be a pain. Alright. If I can grab this without taking damage, that'd be good. Alright, nice. Let's wait for this purple gas to appear. Oh. If you jump on top of the stream, it doesn't actually drop it. And then, if I go fast enough, I'm probably gonna grab this mushroom. Okay. I can go on top of the mushrooms and climb to the top of this, and this is the end of the level. If I do it fast enough, I do, like, save a small chunk of time. It's equally the same as just going around, but for interesting strats, that's one of them I go for. It's fairly easy once you learn how it works, but, yeah. Right now, I need to go up and see Hermione in the girls' bathroom. She's making the Polyjuice Potion. I gotta deliver her the ingredients. However, before I go there, I need to skip Dumbledore. Dumbledore is a 2.5-minute cutscene that I'd rather not watch, and I can't skip it. So, the way I skip it is very interesting. If I come over to this stair here, and before it moves, I jump on top of the staircase, walk up here, and hold. Oh, okay. That's perfectly fine. As long as I hit the cutscene. A little bit of interesting movement there. I'll do it normally. I was trying to do doubles inputs. Oh, okay. Try this again. There we go. So, Nick is sitting there. He's right over there. And Nick sits there and has this huge, like, barrier around him. And this barrier is. It extends a little bit out to the railing, and if you time your jump, you can get sort of a moving platform boost off of the staircase, and that gives you enough speed to shoot past the little bubble trigger that's surrounding him, and you can land past the railing, and you don't have to talk to Dumbledore. All he tells you is Fox is a phoenix, and he gets reborn. That's basically it. And Harry says he's innocent. Like, there's nothing of value in that cutscene to me. Plot-wise, it's a good cutscene. Speedrun-wise, it's 2.5 minutes, and I don't want to sit through that. So I'm glad we don't have to sit through it. This is the Goyle's hair section, the final ingredient for the Polyjuice Potion. I need someone's hair. A little bit of movement there. You can strafe around that little pillar and jump around it quite easily. Before it was called Dumb Goyle, but it's not as dumb anymore because we finally went to Sempra. Yeah, that was a running joke because before we used to go around that room and it saves only like a couple seconds. Okay, I need to not take damage. If I take damage, I can pick up a chocolate frog later on, but I really don't want to take any damage because I'm at Wow, the Rick Sempra just came back. Good
job.
So I'm gonna stand here, and what this does is it manipulates these two snails to charge at me. And that just makes me able to push him in at spring time. So I pushed him with one defendo. There is a trick right here called Foil Wall Walk. However, I'm playing at an FPS that doesn't allow it. This one prefers smaller frame rates. Compared to other tricks which prefer higher frame rates, and the higher frame rate tricks are Richter's Emperor Skip and Chamber Wall Walk. And I'm going at the same speed, it's just the frame rate is slightly different. And I'm playing on Direct 3D, which means I have to lock my frame rate, and I use the frame rate twice.
God, I love PC games.
It's so finicky. Oh, I got the save book. Whatever. So, this is the end of Goyle. And then soon we'll be Goyle. And then we get to go through the Slithering Common Room. And that one has interesting strats as well. I'm gonna wait for this. Okay. I have bad memories with that specific haystack. Oh wow, that barely missed me. If you get hit while in a ledge climb, you get frozen for roughly 6 seconds. 6-8 seconds, and there's nothing you can do about it but just sit there and watch your character just stand idle. And if you get a ledge boost, he just like stands in the air as well, it's kinda nice. And if I line this up correctly, I should get a hair sample. Alright, good. Now, as we continue on, we finally have to go make the Polyjuice Potion, and I guess I'll do a little bit of interesting tech here. Oh no, I gotta set up my fingers correctly. Dude, why isn't it working? There we go. So I'm walking forward, we'll go into the side as well. A little something you can do with double inputs. Not double inputs, what's it called? We don't even like have a name for it, do we? Huh.
Make up a name, right?
Make up our name. Well, I'm using two keys. I'm gonna count two keys.
Alright, it's a good name.
It's not gonna stay, though.
Pretty solid.
Right here, I have just enough health that if I come on top of the staircase and jump, I'm gonna fall right down to the door and just go right through. Did I not bind this key? No, I did bind this key. Huh. Interesting. Weird. Okay, I guess it doesn't work on the key. So now we're going into the Slithering Common Rooms. Wow, okay, it really does not want to work. Whatever. I guess it's, I don't know. It's
I love
weird.
PC games.
PC games are quite interesting. This is a little bit of an unskippable cutscene. We learned the password to the Slithering Common Room, and you get to hear Goyle's voice actor. So.
Pure blood.
What's the password? But I can use that to get into the Slithering Common Room.
Alright, we can get into the Slithering Common Room now. So if you didn't see there for like a split second, I was Harry's model. Oh wow, I missed the switch entirely. Nice. What this game does, it loads game states, and when you hit that trigger, it changes the game state from one to another, so it swaps from Harry's model to Goyle's. And it's just a little small thing you can see if you like pay attention. But I'm just trying to get through this as fast. That just missed it entirely. Okay. So now that I've gone down that section, I've reoriented this room. And in front of me is the bridge. We can actually skip this bridge, and we call it bridge skip. There's two different types of bridge skips. This is one variation of it. The other variation is very, very dependent on FPS. And even still, it's not RTA viable. There's a whole upper section that I could go around and hit that flipendo. But if I do my jumps correctly, I don't lose any momentum. I don't lose any momentum, and I can actually hit it from below. So that little bridge skip saves like 8 seconds, if I remember correctly. There's very minor skips here and there, and that's what makes this game like fun for me. Is you can play as slow as you want, or you can try and optimize it as fast as you want. Before we found Richter's Emperor Skip, world record was like 46:58. Second was 47:05, I think. 4707, then 4713, 4714. It was very optimized. Like, saving those seconds really mattered. Now with Rick's Temper Skip, we didn't have to go through that whole process again. But we'll be getting more
Something's
runs to, like,
not right.
optimize
was that,
that level.
Professor Snape? Colors I just saw?
So this whole section was very, very...
what are you doing
okay,
down
you're
here?
Being me.
Who are you?
Something.
Usually that guy doesn't chase me that far.
Professor Snape.
This section was actually very scary, like in a normal playthrough, until you like figured out that you could just run away from them. they're not that fast at all. Like, they can't outrun you. If they outran you, that'd be really hard. But normally that one Slytherin that chased me doesn't chase me that far, and that's a kind of shocking thing. Sometimes he does, and most of the times he just kind of stands there and says, "You're not a Slytherin." A little bit of more stair parkour here. Alright. And now we're entering Spongify. And this is another arrow key challenge, so I'm just gonna press the inputs and hope that fake inputs don't happen.
Concentrate on the symbol before you. Don't let my good looks distract you. The wand that appears in front of you is going to move around the shape. When the wand is positioned perfectly over the arrow, press the corresponding arrow key to hit the target. There are three parts to this exercise.
I like how
in
it gives you a tutorial
you
every single time you do this.
And accurately hit
in case you didn't get it the last two
in
times.
In order to go forward.
Hey, if you
Round
need to
one,
refresh yourself
begin.
After going through like two dungeons, these are the tutorials for you.
It's been a whole 10 minutes, man. I can't remember that.
Hey, what happened 10 minutes ago?
Well done, Harry. You've advanced to the next round.
Once
Five
again.
5 points to Gryffindor. Round two,
Yeah, if I do
begin.
Actually fail this, I would get once again, because it's locked in. Once again, it's just a little dumb thing. Before you'd fail Rick DeSempra, and you'd hear him say once again like 5 times. But now, the only time you hear once again is if you accidentally fail an arrow key.
Well
or get
done,
a
Harry.
Input.
You've advanced to the next round.
10 points
to
Gryffindor.
Ooh. Round three, begin.
All right. So Spongify.
Great work, lad. You completed all of the exercises.
Before December skip.
15
points it's actually, I believe, equally as long as the arrow key challenge. Maybe a little less than the arrow key challenge. So you spend a majority of time doing those. But Spongify grants you access to these tiles. Interesting property about them is they will always go the same distance as they're programmed. Like, they're programmed to go to a certain point or a certain length away. And you can use that up to your advantage. If I also stay on the edge of this room, there's a small cutscene, but the trigger doesn't extend there in the full room, and if the cutscene does extend, if I hit the cutscene, that platform right there raises up.
Spongify.
And I would just have to go through that entire room. I really don't want to. I jumped on top of that red pot. I could be wrong. Look more like a potion. And that just skips like another small cutscene. And that skips spawning fire crabs I had to deal with. Yeah. As well, it sets up for jump onto that tile much more easily. Right here is another moving platform boost. If I get on top of this, I can shoot it. And I just kind of jump. I get to where I'm going. And this one is really interesting. I'm supposed to go over there. But if I strafe to the left there, I can actually grab it from much lower. And that skips like half of Spongify.
Would you be interested in trading?
So, very simple trick, but it's very nice that you don't have to go through those later sections with like pistons that push you randomly.
Do we have time for a couple quick donations?
Yeah, you got time.
We have a $500 donation from those awesome guys. This goes towards Dishonored's Brigmore Witches DLC. Keep being awesome. As well as a $150 donation from Matt Lish. Yes, yes, well done, Harry, well done, Harry. However, Dishonored is easily the best game at SGDQ. This donation goes towards Brigmore Witches.
the much better of the two DLC runs.
Nice.
All right, what's coming up next? I'm trying to remember, because it's either I go to forest right away or to a cutscene. I believe it's a cutscene. It's a cutscene. Okay.
Harry was,
if you have more donations,
by
like
the memory
that's the time.
Tom Riddle showed him.
All right. We have a $50 donation from Arazorize 183. I hope
Come
I pronounced that correct. Hey, Pokemon Rocks, Era here. Just wanted to say you're an amazing individual and an awesome speedrunner. The Racefire community is so proud of you.
Evening,
we hope you enjoy yourself
Why
at SGDQ.
Are you doing down here, Tom?
It's all over.
$20 from Anonymous.
Kill anyone.
Thank you for playing my favorite game growing up. P.S. Avada Kedavra. Kill the animals.
The least Hogwarts can do is make sure the thing
$15 from
slaughtered.
Flying Sea Dragons.
It wasn't him.
So
he
great to see a Harry
never.
Potter game at GDQ. I played these
Stand
games all the time
aside.
As a kid, and I still play them at least once per year. Good luck. My donation goes towards killing the animals in Super Metroid. Flipendo. $10 from Jesty. Greetings from CT. First time donator. And first time watching SGDQ live. My friend got me into it by watching Outlast speedruns from last year. And now I'm hooked. And now I'm here, watching Harry Potter at 5 a.m. because it's my favorite game. Thanks for everything you do, and happy to support this amazing cause. Oh, and kill them animals.
Alright, so now that we've finished the Aragog cutscene, I guess it is the Aragog cutscene, but it's the memory that Tom Riddle shows us, and in that one, we learned that Hagrid apparently was the person who set the large creature in the castle loose. We know that's completely incorrect, because I read the books and I know it's the Basilisk spoilers.
Wow.
Wow. Dang, dude.
But now I've taken the Forbidden Forest, and in here there's not too much, but you have to go fight Aragog. That's a very wonderful boss fight. But in this area, there's two chocolate frogs, and I'm going to be trying to get both of them. I do want that one specifically. So, and if I do this correctly, I can jump on top of this little tree over here and then jump back onto the bridge. What that does is there's a trigger on that bridge that lowers it, and it just saves time. It saves, I believe, 1.5 seconds. And then if you just strafe on this, instead of going to the platform, you switch to the platform. And that's another interesting thing about SpongeBob Hunters, is if you're on a SpongeBob Hunter and you use it, you don't get any fall damage. And we'll be using that later on as well. In the chamber. There's like a 1 pixel jump there that you don't get Electra. These guys almost hit me, that would have lost half my health. This is why I picked up the frog in the first place, as well as for the best fight later.
Defendo!
I'm also going to pick up
Does strafing in the air actually increase your speed?
No. In fact, jumping is much slower than actually walking. So I'm trying to minimize jumping as much as possible. Like, right here... Oh, whoops. Little wonky hitboxes. Right here you can jump over these Pokemon moves, or you can just kind of go to the right here and avoid them entirely. And this is the Aragog boss fight. As a meme, raise your volumes.
It's him! My
but really, it's a loud boss fight, and hopefully doesn't get over.
Reminder that,
yeah, so every time I use a spell or something that Aragog is connected to, he does give off a sound effect. And in fact, I do have to spam him multiple times with the Zentral, and this skips having to wait an extra phase. Alright, so he's giving me bad RNG here. He gave me one or two attacks, and that is the slowest of the two. This is always a charge. That's pretty much the entire boss fight. I just, wow, it gave me really bad RNG. Alright, so now he's gonna charge at me again. And he always charges in the second and fourth phase, as well as stomping on the fourth round. Now, I don't think it's actually possible to kill him early, because these attacks do, like, take quite a bit of time. But I almost got his health bar down to, like, I almost killed him like really quickly, but I don't think it's actually possible. I did not forget to move in here. There was a run a while back. I got too excited, and that cutscene got followed wrong. I did the next cutscene's inputs, and if you do the next cutscene's inputs, you just fall off from the top of the stairs, and you die. So I lost a record pace run like a year ago. Well, I think it was a year ago. It was a long time ago, but it was kind of funny. This cauldron I hit earlier has a chance of dropping a bean or a chocolate frog. Ideally, I want a chocolate frog, but if I get a bean, it's no big deal as well. So right here, we're entering the chamber, and you're supposed to go around this room. You can just kind of jump over this gap and continue on as you want. And this chamber is filled with many, many tricks. And some of them are forgiving, some of them are unforgiving. This one right here isn't really a trick, but it's a setup. And I might have to wait for these cycles because I failed it, probably. I think I'm good. Alright, good.
Nice.
Ideally, you don't want to hit that grate, and it makes it much easier. I got it anyways, because I went for it. I probably shouldn't have gone for it. Oh, there. You can grab the sledge. Alright, let me try again. There we go.
Nice.
Normally it's not that tight, but I did hit the little grate that came down, and that does cause Harry to go a bit slower. But it doesn't matter, because I made it. There we go. Oh, I missed that one. Alright, so coming up here is Pixie Proxy, and Pixie Proxy basically involves using this Pixie right here. I think I might have stunned him too late. Nice. So Pixie Proxy allows me to get to the middle platform, and from there, I don't have to use this entire room at all. And I hit the Defendos as I was flying by just to save a bit of time, and that wasn't the entire room. It's very long, and with Pixie Proxy, it makes it very short. These crabs like to fire a lot of fire at you, and hopefully they'll get any damage, but sometimes they can hit you when it's perfectly fine.
Do we have time for a couple of more donations?
Yeah.
Alright. We have $20 from Polly. All the Harry Potter games are awful, so I can't wait to see one of them being destroyed. Good luck, Harry. $20 from Respirt. I hope I pronounced that correctly. Shoutouts to my main man, pok3monrocks, for doing an awesome job with Harry Potter 2, and to everyone who stayed up super early to support our boy. Best of luck on the rest of the run, and don't forget to raise your volumes. bit late there, but... $10 from Blasphemia. Nice work, guys. Keep it going.
Alright, so coming up here is another small skip. This one is by far one of the weirdest ones. It involves a bunch of collision, and from the save book, I'm getting it just in case it happens, but this bridge here, if you just kind of walk on this edge and hold up to the right, there's a bunch of collision down here. So I don't actually have to wait for this bridge to reopen, or even like solve the puzzle that's intended to like keep it from falling. And if I jump at the right point here, nice, I can walk on top of that wall. It saves like less than any time, really. But it skips a cutscene, I don't have to be chased by a boulder. And I have like a free cam, basically. If you get hit by that cutscene, your camera locks behind you and like really high. But I can, you know, there's a boulder up there. Normally it'd be following me, but you know, it doesn't matter anymore because it's not gonna follow me anyways. And here is chamber wall walk. Never mind, there's not chamber wall walk. I wasn't supposed to hit that was purely muscle memory. Whoops. But it basically would skip having to wait for that to come back. And... I'm debating if I want to make the second potion, but I don't think I'll need it.
Nah, you'll be fine. Don't worry about it.
As long as I don't take too much damage from here. There you go. I'm not going to grab the save book in case I do need it, but I shouldn't need it because the snake is pretty easy. There's a snake. The way you fight this guy is with the sword of Gryffindor, and just fire a charge down, and he takes damage. And if I do it correctly, I can stun block his entire first phase. And so he dies. Oh darn. A little too less damage. And here comes second phase. Second phase is a bit more tricky. The problem with second... Oh, God. I took a ton of damage there. We're good, though. The problem with second phase is I can three-round him. And three-rounding is very, very hard. If I get it, that'd be nice. I'm going to go for it. I don't think I have enough damage. I definitely don't have enough damage for getting hit there. Yeah. All right, I'm just going to play this safe and not take any more damage. That's perfectly fine. So I actually can't kill him now until he comes to this little area. So there, now he's dead, and time is coming up rather quickly. So now that the snake's dead, we gotta, you know, go to the Gryffindor, or not Gryffindor, come up, the Great Hall, and receive our ceremony, and get the House Cup. And time is now.
Nice.
So that's the entire game. Before we get to the House Cup right here, I'd like to point out that I have 321 house points, and Slytherin has 670. So keep that in mind.
Silence.
And this should only take a couple seconds. Points, you know.
This House Cup ceremony brings the school year.
So good job, Harry. You've successfully beat the entire game and cheated your way to the House Cup.
Without further ado, I shall now present the cup to the Hogwarts house with the most points.
Think we'll take it again this year? After you and Harry saved Hogwarts, I should think so.
In fourth place,
Ravenclaw.
Freaking Ravenclaw.
In third place, Hufflepuff.
Who?
Thank you.
Does anybody like Hufflepuff? Honestly.
Literally who?
All right, who's going to win, guys? Hufflepuff. I already spoiled it, but... Second place house. Who's going to win?
You, Gryffindors. You're naturally second best.
Wow.
You won't steal a house cup from Slytherin like you did last year.
After barely escaping disqualification, Slytherin.
What?
Yo, that's not fair.
First place, and the house cup goes to Gryffindor.
What is this?
So we got the house cup, guys. We won.
Yeah. Wow. You literally cheated.
Reminder, I don't have enough house points to win.
You're literally cheating right now.
Literally cheating.
Embarrassing. PC runs, I swear.
Ugh.
Every time.
Alright. But that's Harry Potter too.
Alright. Thank you, Pokemon Rocks, for the great run of Harry Potter 2. Coming up next, we have Barbie Game Girl, ran by John Carls, followed by Speedy Gonzales, Los Gatos, Bandidos, ran by Keveridge.